Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Conversations with the one and only J-Man. Your morning will never be the same. Here we go.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the color on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see their need? A summer disregard, a broken bottle top, and a one-man soul. They follow each other on the wind, you know, 'cause they got nowhere to go. That's why I want you to know I'm starting with the man in the mirror. I'm asking him to change his ways, and no message could have been any clearer. If you wanna make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and then make a change. Oh, na 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 na. Oh, 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 I've been a victim of a selfish kind of love. It's time that I realize there was so no hope that I needed to know.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. Thank y'all so much for joining Coffee and Conversation this morning. I pray that you all had a great weekend, and to the mothers, happy belated Mother's Day. I hope that you all had a great, great time Sunday. Let me say good morning to everyone. Good morning, Jackie. Good morning, Yogi. Good morning, Nurse Rachel. Good morning, Tony. Good morning. Good to have you all on the show this morning. Yogi, we're praying for your son. We are praying for your son. And good morning to my warriors. My warriors out there at Emory Winship Cancer Center. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. We're praying with you. And we know that you are fighting a great fight. We know that you all are fighting a great fight and that you all are giving cancer hell. My brother is doing well. He's on week 4, I believe, out with Emory Winship Cancer Center. So we ask that, all of us are praying for those that are dealing with not only just cancer, but any sicknesses. We're praying. I want to get into this morning's conversation. I played the song Man in a Mirror because I wanted to go with the mindset of mirror moment. Oftentimes I always say, I'm in the middle of saying something, I say, oh, this is a mirror moment. And what I'd ask you to do, if you can't look in a mirror, pretend that your hand is a mirror. Let me give you the backdrop with that. Let me give you the backdrop of why I say that. I'll use this analogy. Last year, I went to the doctor because I thought I needed glasses. I get into the doctor's office and they sit you in this chair and they ask you to read the letters. So she said, read the letters. I went all the way down to the bottom and I read those letters. She looked at me crazy. She said, put this over your eye. Put it over one eye. She said, read it. I went to the bottom, read it. The bottom letters, switched eyes, read the bottom letters. She said, "This, you actually have perfect vision." I said, "No, when I get ready to read, it seemed like the letters get unfocused." She said, "Oh, you just need reading glasses." So she put the thing, thing in front of me and told me to look through this. And she started clicking. And the words became clearer, and with every click, it became clearer and clearer. I said, that's it right there. She said, yeah, you just need reading glasses. You have no problem with seeing things in front of you, way, way out in front of you. The problem is dealing with reading what is in front of you. What is in front of you. I'm using that analogy for our conversation this morning. When I'm on my shows, I normally try to have my listeners create a mindset that if they can see what's not there right now, that you can achieve that. You can have that. You can do that. If it's perfect health, if it's financial stuff, if it's starting a new business, no matter what it is, you can have that if you put it in your mind to go after it. But that's in a distance. The second part of the conversation, is, in order to achieve that thing in the distance that's not there, you have to do what's in front of you. You have to deal with what's in front of you right now. We can sit and name and claim all kinds of things But if we don't take care of what's in front of us right now, we're going to miss what's down the road. We're going to miss what's down the road for us because we don't want to take care of what's in front of us right now. The longevity of an of an idea or a desire is good. But taking care of what is in front, we want to be healed. We want to get better physically. And the doctor says, I need you to take these pills every day. I need you to exercise every day. I need you to go on your walks every day. And we're excited. We're going to get better. I'm getting healed. I'm getting better. But you're not taking your medicine. I'm looking down the road of feeling better. But I'm not exercising. Your financial advisor tells you, you can have this much money in the bank in 5 years. Here's what I need you to do. I need you to invest $5 a day or $50 a week. But you don't do that. You're still excited about 5 years down the road, I'm gonna have this much money, but you're not doing what needs to be done right now. What is your mirror conversation with yourself about your future? What is your mirror conversation with yourself about your future? What are you telling yourself, I need to change? If I want this, I have to do this. If I want that, I have to do this. Today, I have to change my mindset today. I have to change the way I do things today. Because apparently, what I've been doing has not gotten me to the goal that I want to be at. So what changes are you making? Are you listening to your doctors? Are you listening to your career coaches? Are you listening to your financial advisor? Are you listening to your mentors? Are you listening to your pastors? Are you listening to your leaders? And are you making the adjustments? There it is. Are you making the necessary adjustments? If I could use lawn care. There's a style of grass or a look of grass that people actually love. And it's that, you know, that thick green grass. And you pass by somebody's house and they got the nice edge yard and the thick grass. But they put in work every day to have that look. Instead of doing the same old thing. If to have grass like that, you have to start off with a low cut. But the next time you cut the grass, you have to adjust the size. You have to make an adjustment on the lawnmower. And then the time after that, you have to make another adjustment on the lawnmower. Until you get to the desired height of grass that you want. If you keep cutting the grass on the first setting, you're going to keep having low grass. A lot of us mentally, emotionally, keep cutting our grass too low, expecting a different outcome. Cut it down low. You grow mentally, you grow emotionally, you grow spiritually. And then when they say, we got to get better. And what you do, you cut everything away. No, you have to make adjustments. What adjustments are you making in your life? Think about it. What adjustments are you making to better your life? Because as you grow, as you get smarter, as you find when you know better, you do better. We can't say that's how it always done, and we can't say, well, that's how they're doing it. No, for you. When you look in your mirror, what's good for you? That's the conversation you have to have with yourself. What's good for you? You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Mac.
The truth can hurt you, or the truth can change you. What will truth do to you?
I just wanna be happy. But if I keep on doing the things that keep on bringing me pain, there's no one else I can blame if I'm not happy. Wasted time, but now I can see the biggest enemy, it was me. So I'm not happy. Cry yourself to sleep. Shout and raise your hands. It won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
Preach.
If you're tired of being the same, if you're tired of things not changing, it's time for you to get out the way. Don't get stuck in how you feel. Say, Jesus, take the wheel. He knows the road that you need to take.
But it only works if
you wanna be happy.
Look at yourself and say,
don't you wanna be happy?
Yeah.
I just wanna be happy. But if I keep on giving my heart for people to tear apart, the healing will never start. So I can be happy.
Yes, Lord.
Will I ever be happy? Cry yourself to sleep. Shout and raise your hands. It won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
If I'm talking to you, then say,
if you're tired of being the same, if you're tired of things not changing, it's time for you to get out the way.
You've been there too long.
Don't get stuck.
I feel this one right here.
It's so easy to complain, addicted to the pain.
Yes.
You give your heart, they push it away.
But I got good news for you.
Jesus knows just how you feel. Just let him take the wheel.
Hallelujah.
The love you need, he already gave.
But the question is,
do you want to be happy?
If you're tired of you, then say,
I just wanna be happy.
Now, if you really mean that, open up your heart and say,
let me hear you say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you're tired of going in circles,
let me hear you say, yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Tired of making the same mistakes,
let me hear you say, yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah.
But now's your chance,
let me hear you say, yeah,
say, yeah,
yeah.
Are you ready? Come on!
Don't get stuck in how you feel. Say, Jesus, take the wheel.
Won't you do it?
He knows the road that you need to take.
It's so easy to complain.
It's so easy to complain.
Come on!
Addicted to the pain.
Yeah.
You give your heart, they push it away.
But somebody that'll never leave you.
Jesus knows just how you feel.
Yes, sir.
Just let
question is,
do you want to be happy?
Took a long time, but I'm ready.
I just want to be happy.
Thank you, Lord. Every day, ask yourself,
do you want to be happy?
Yes. Pull over. Let him drive.
I just want to be happy.
You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we are on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. If you want to be happy, if you want to get to a place where that you've been dreaming of, that you've been desiring, you know, we are our biggest enemy. There's a saying that says the biggest enemy is the inner me. Our greatest enemy is our inner me. the distance to your destination that of where you want to be starts with the very first step that's in front of you. Many of us are naming and claiming stuff down the road, but don't know how. It's like you name and claim this car. You remember when we was kids? Oh, that's my car. That's my car. That's my car. And in our minds, we literally thought that's gonna, but we don't know how to drive. We don't have a driver's license. That's my house. That's my house. That's your house. That's my house. We don't even have a job to maintain it. We have to get to the point where what's in front of us, the step that's in front of us, the step that is in front of us is going to be the thing that causes us to maneuver, causes us to change, causes us to grow. So my conversation this morning is simple. Start with the man, woman in the mirror. Start looking in the mirror and start right there. For me to have a better day, what can I do? Don't worry about tomorrow. Because if I say, what can I do to have a better today? Anything I change, anything that I do today affects the rest of my life. The way I think, if I decide that I'm just going to be this way mentally, it's a decision we make. I understand that there are different circumstances and we go through. I get it. I'm not saying you're wrong. We have to learn how to adjust. But this is just how I'm always is. Then learn how to adjust. Adjusting promotes growth. That's a good way to look at this whole conversation. Adjusting promotes growth. What's attached to you right now that you need to cut away, to get rid of? That's literally attached to you right now. What do I need to do to get rid of that? I was outside the other day and I was looking at this rose bush that was growing. And I had to go in there and cut some of the smaller branches off because it was taking away nutrients that the flowers needed. There wasn't anything growing on it. So I had to learn how to prune it back so that the necessary things that needed to grow on the tree would. You're just like that rose bush. You have a lot of things in you that needs to flourish, that needs to grow. But there are things attached to you that's sucking away from your roses blooming or flourishing the way that it can. Today I just ask you to think about what is holding you back. Now I want you to have this mindset as we close and as we think about what we're going to do today, because there's a future in front of us that's waiting on us. And I need you to have this positive energy about you. I need you to get up and say, nothing is going to stop me from having my better day now. You know the commercial, it's my money and I want it now. It's my happiness and I want it now. It's my joy and I want it now. It's my peace and I want it now. It's my healing and I want it now. And it starts right there with your very next step. So do this for me. Make your very next step a dance. Make your very next step a dance and sing this song to you. Ain't no stopping us now. When we got it, we got this. My brother always said, you got this. We got this. So let's make our next step a dance. Look, I appreciate you all. Thank you so much for hanging out with me this morning. I pray that God does something wonderful and excellent in you all's lives today. See you Thursday. Holla at your boy. It's all good. It's all gravy.
Yeah. Okay, y'all. It's time to sing our song. Polishing up.